Welcome to Arvind Singh Academy, and this is another session of arithmetic progression. I hope you have studied well and revised all the previous things what we have discussed in the previous classes. So let me discuss today about this arithmetic progression, some more questions, some more concepts we will learn today, and thereafter we will go for another ideas. So today session is basically on the application of the previous formula. What we have learned that t in nth term is a plus n minus 1 into d. So with more applications I would like to throw on it. So let me discuss some questions. If 10th term of an AP, question is, if 17th term, say like 17th term of AP is exceeds 10 by its 7th term, then find the common difference of AP. So 17th term. Now how to solve this? Solution of this type of question. Let A be the first term and B be the common difference. B be the common difference of AP. Difference of AP. Then T17 minus T7th is equal to 10. This is given as per question. So T17th is what? A plus 16D. And T7th is A plus 6D is equal to 10. Now A plus 16D minus A minus 6D is equal to 10. A cancel. 10D is equal to 10. So D is equal to 1. That will be the answer, and we have to find common difference, and common difference is 1. So this type of questions can be solved easily by using the formula. You can write the answer. Now let me discuss the other questions today. Which term of the following sequence is negative? First negative term. Which term? 16, 54, right? 48, like this. So we don't know which term is negative. Here, what we learn about that this in solution, I can write first term is 60, and what is D? D is common difference, that is 54 minus 60, which is minus 6. So D is minus 6, A is 60. Now we don't know which term is first negative. So we can write let Tn term, that is nth term, is first negative term. Tn term is first negative term. So Tn is less than 0. Is negative term? For negative, it must be less than 0. So Tn is what? A plus n minus 1 into t should be less than 0. A is what? A is 60 plus n minus 1 into t. D is what? Minus 6 should be less than 0. 60 minus 6n plus 6 is less than 0. 60 plus 6 is 66 is less than 6n. 6n would become this side, and n is greater than 11. 6 will divide this side. 11, 6 are 66. N must be greater than 11. This means n is 12. So 12th term must be first negative term in the sequence. So therefore 12th term is first negative term. negative term of the sequence. Twelfth term is first negative term of the sequence. N must be greater than 11. Greater than 11, what will be the term? 12th term. So 12th term will be first negative term of the sequence. So similar type of questions can be asked in examination for 2 marks. You will be able to solve if you have such concepts. Right? Now, the next level of question that I am going to discuss here. Some more questions related to where unknown variables are given. Right? So let me discuss few more questions. One of them is question. If 9th term of an AP is 17 and 17th term of that AP is 9. 17th term of that AP is 9. Find its 26th term. Right, 26th term. This is the question. So in such question, what to deal with? Try to understand. I am writing here solution. Solution is, what is given here? Try to understand. Here, T9 is given 17th. And 17th term is given 9. Vice versa. 9 term 17, 17th term is 9. This is what to information given. And we have to find the solution. And we have to find 26th term. That what we have find is T26. 26th term is what that we have to calculate. So how to calculate? We can write again. Let A be the first term. And B be the common difference. Common difference. Of AP. Right? So, T9th is what? T9th is nothing else but A plus T9 is, since T9 is 17, which gives A plus 8D is equal to 17. T17 is equal to 9, which will give A plus 16D is equal to, A plus 16 is equal to 9. This is the first equation, this is the second equation. If I could subtract this, what will happen? Second minus first. What will come? 16 minus 8 is equal to 8D. A minus A cancel. And 9 minus, this is minus 8. Even I can write second minus first, then this will be minus 8. 9 minus minus 17 minus 8. So D is equal to minus 1. And putting in first, we get what? D is minus 1. So A minus 8 will come. If I put D minus 1, minus 8 will come. And minus 8 will come this side, it will be plus 8. 17 plus 8 is 25. A is 25. Now 26th term is what? So T26th is equal to A plus 25D. That is A is 25 and D is 25 into minus 1. So 25 minus 25 is 0. 25 minus 25 is 0. So that will be 0. Right? 25 minus 25 is 0. Got it? So 25 minus 25 is 0. It means you see the analogy. If 9th term is 17, 17th term is 9, then 9 plus 17th, that is 26th term is 0. So anywhere you can apply this technique to find the solution of different questions. For example, if someone say, okay, if 11th term of an AP, term of an AP is 26 and 26th term of that AP, 26th term of that AP, is 11, then of course 37th term of that AP is what? Term of that AP is what? 0. Because 11 plus 26 is 37. Similarly, if someone is given like this, that if mth term of an AP is n, and nth term of that AP is m, mth term of AP is n, and nth term is m, then what is the m plus nth term? Mth term of an AP is n, and nth term of that AP is m. Then find its m plus nth term. Then what will you write? You will write answer 0. So this is a tricky approach. You can solve your own by using the same pack. You will be able to solve it. So this is a tricky approach. If you keep in mind, definitely you will be able to solve very quickly. Now write the 6 questions. That if mth term of an AP is 1 by n, not n, but 1 by n, and nth term of that AP is 1 by m, then find its first m plus nth term. 2 question I am writing here, m plus nth term, and the second question is mnth term. 2 question I am writing here, and try to understand this, how to deal with such question. Let me write this. Mth term of an AP is 1 by n, and nth term is 1 by m. Mth term is 1 by n. This can be written as a plus m minus 1 into t is equal to 1 by n. Nth term of that AP is 1 by m. This can be written as a plus n minus 1 into t is equal to 1 by n. Now subtract first minus second. What will happen? If you subtract, sign will change. Everybody know? Sign will change. A minus A cancel. Now it will come M minus N into D. Because minus 1 and minus 1. Minus 1, minus 1 can be also cancelled. It would be plus 1. After taking D common. And that will be 1 by N minus 1 by M. So if I write here M minus N into D, that will also come M minus N upon MN. MN, MN cancel, since M is not equal to N. Two distinct terms, clearly it is written. So D is nothing else but 1 by MN. This is third equation. Now putting the value of D in 1. Putting the value of D in equation 1. What we will get? A plus m minus 1 into d is equal to 1 by n. Isn't it? This is what given? First equation. We have to calculate value of a. D is 1 by mn is equal to 1 by n. So a plus mn multiply by m, m into 1 by mn minus 1 into 1 by mn, that is 1 by n. So a plus m and m cancel. 1 by n minus 1 by mn is equal to 1 by n. 1 by n and 1 by n cancel. And what is left? A is equal to minus 1 by mn will come this side. It will be plus 1 by mn. So this is equation 4. Now what I determine? I have calculated A. I have calculated D here. Two things have been calculated. Now what I have to calculate? M plus nth term. And second question was mnth term. So these two things I have to calculate. So let me write this. Now mnth term. First question is, Tm plus nth term is a plus m minus 1 into d. You know the formula, na? That nth term is a plus n minus 1 into d. So here m plus n minus 1 into d. And what is a? A is nothing else but 1 by mn. And m plus n minus 1, d is also 1 by mn. If I would have taken 1 by mn common, what is left here? 1 plus, what is left there? M plus n minus 1. 1 cancels. And now what is left? Left m plus n upon mn, that is 1 by m plus 1 by n. That will be the answer. So m plus nth term is 1 by m plus 1 by n. In general, we can use this as a trick that if mth term is 1 by n, nth term is 1 by m, then sum of m plus nth term is 1 by m plus 1 by n. Second part of that question was tm nth term. That is a plus mn minus 1 into d. In that case also, I can write 1 by mn plus mn minus 1 into 1 by mn. In that case, it will be mn plus mn multiplied by 1 by mn is 1. Minus 1 multiplied by 1 by mn is mn. These two are cancelled, so 1 will be answered. So in general, we can memorize this region to find answer of all other objective questions which can be solved by using this fact. So I hope you got it. Mth term is 1 by n. Let me remind you once again. Nth term is 1 by m. If a is the first term, then I can write here a plus m minus 1 to d, that is 1 by n. And nth term, so n minus 1 is 1 by m. After subtracting, this will come m minus n into d, that is 1 by n minus 1 by m. And now m minus n into d, after taking LCM, that will come m minus n divided by LCM mn. So m and mn cancel because m and n are two distinct terms in this question. So 1 by mn left. D has been calculated. Putting the value of d in equation 1, you will be able to analyze, calculate value of a that has been calculated. And after a and d is known, you can calculate any number of terms like m plus nth term, a plus m minus 1 into d. Putting the value of a and d, we can calculate this is the value. And mnth term, again, we can put the value of a and d, we will be able to calculate it. So hopefully you got this and you understand it well. I hope so. If you are not able to understand anything, you can mail me with my email ID arvindsinghacademy@gmail.com or arvindsinghacademy@gmail.com. And for more questions and for assignments, also for theory parts, you can visit our website www.arvindsinghacademy.com. So let me discuss some more questions today. So let me write one more question. That is question number 8. What is this? And question is that a man deposit 100 rupees in first month, rupee 100 in first month, and rupee 150 in second month, rupee 200 in third month, and so on. In which month he has to deposit rupee 1000 if he proceeds, increases his deposit in same pattern, in same way or same pattern. So this this is the language, something written. Other question is very simple, but it is written something which is in form of a story. That the first term, solution is, first month he has deposit 100, this is the first term, right? Second term is 150, that is second term in second month. Third month he has deposited 200, so this is in third month. And similarly, if he has proceeded, then in each month he has to deposit 1000 rupees. So TN term basically we have to calculate. First term, second term, third term is given. What is A? 100. What is D? That is T2 minus T1. 150 minus 100. What is that? 50. Now we have to calculate TN. TN is 100,000 given. It means TN is A plus N minus 1 into D is equal to 1000. A is 100. N minus 1 into 50 is equal to 1000. So after doing this, what will happen if you proceed this? This 100 will come this side, it will be subtracted. So N minus 1 into 50 is equal to 900. Now N minus 1 is equal to 900 divided by 50, that is 18, and N is equal to 19. That would be the answer. So in 19th month, that is in 19th month, he will deposit how much? 1000 he will deposit in 19 months, right? So that is the question. So some language type questions can be solved by using this method, and this is some language type question which can be solved by using this fact. Here also you have to find the number of terms. So basically, out of the four variety, we have to either calculate the number of terms, that is the value of N, or common difference, or first term, or any number of terms which is supposed to have answer. Now, sometimes, the another question I am taking here, which term of the sequence is first negative? Why I am writing this question again? Because here something special I have to tell you. Here the question is 67, 64, and like this 61, like this. So here again I can suppose solution of that will be, let first term is negative, let TN term is first negative term. So TN must be less than 0. Therefore, I can write here A plus N minus 1 into D should be less than 0. A is 67, right now? 67, and D is minus 3. So minus 3 should be less than 0. And this employee 67 minus 3N plus 3 should be less than 0. This employee 67 plus 3, 70 is less than 3N, and N is greater than 70 by 3. 70 by 3 is something, that is 3 to just 6, and 23 sign 1 by 3 is less greater than N, because N is fraction here. So just after that is 23 point something, 24th term would be first negative term. So here N is 24, and 24th term is first negative, because the previous question what I discussed here, that was the integral number. So not always you have to increase 1, but 23 point something, when N is come in fraction, then after that just next integer would be the required number of terms. 24th term would be first negative, right? So this is a specific type of questions that has been discussed here, and this is what I mean to discuss is, you have to calculate the number of terms, you have to know how to apply this, what are the concept behind, how can you find and apply the TN formula, and TN formula can be applied where and where, in which cases we can apply TN formula, that all what we have discussed. And I think you understand it. Well understand that any number of terms, how to calculate, how to find whether a particular term is present in that sequence or not, or how to understand that which term would be in the negative if the sequence is in decreasing order. Hopefully, you enjoyed all this and you are now confident to solve questions related to this type of questions. And if you are not able to do this, revise this once again, watch this video again once, and then definitely you will be able to understand it. Before watching this video, you also requested to watch all previous videos of this chapter so that you can grasp this concept very quickly and easily. I hope you enjoy all this, and thereafter we will solve some other questions in next class, and we will give some other concept as well. That in that class we will use another formula, derive that formula and use of that formula. Till then, bye bye. Thank you. Thank you very much.